Right now, I'm currently in my vocal booth whisper room. I've made 3 videos in the past about this build. In today's video, we're gonna cover ventilation. It's the one thing that this booth does not have. It gets a little warm in here if I'm in here for prolonged periods of time. I'm also gonna cover my impressions of the booth and how well it works. Spoiler alert, it works quite well and I'm pretty happy with it. I'm gonna answer a lot of your questions that I continuously get. So stay tuned to the end of the video for that. And that's what we're gonna cover in this video.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
Make sure that you have notifications turned on for my channel so you don't miss a single episode. And now, a word from our sponsor.
My sponsor, PCBWay, has resumed full printed circuit board production in early March of 2020. Since most of the planet is stuck at home, it's a great time for an electronics project. Get that soldering iron out and let's get making. They're randomly giving away free masks together with your orders to help fight against the COVID-19 virus. Click the link in the description to get your next project started and prevent the spread of the COVID-19 virus. Just like any other project that I do, I usually start with some sort of a sketch, and this is my plan. I'm basically building 240 by 22 by 7 inch boxes that hang on the side of my booth for my ventilation. The top one is going to have the fans in it and draw the air out of the top of the booth. The bottom box is going to be a baffle. I'm using this Silenx silent cooling system here that many of you recommended. It's about 60 bucks on eBay. You plug the fans into this AC controller and then you can vary the fan speed. Not the quietest thing, but it's easy to rig up and I think I can make it work. We'll see. I also got these quick disconnect hose couplers at my local big box retailer. We're going to cannibalize them. For those of you who don't have a 3D printer, the other hose connections I'm actually going to 3D print, and we'll get more into that later in the video. I had the big side pieces pre-cut for me at the local orange big box retailer. We're going to make this whole thing out of half inch MDF, and here I am ripping down the pieces on my table saw. These are 6-inch wide pieces and they get sandwiched in between those big flat pieces that you saw before. Now I'm going to cross cut them here on the sled to get them to the right length. Next, we're going to drill all the holes, and this is where the inlets and the outlets will be for the air to go in and out of the boxes. We will attach the hose adapters, or the 3D printed ones, here into these holes that I'm cutting out on the drill press with this adjustable drill bit. Love that. Slow-mo. Now the Silenx has some bezels that the fans hook into, and we need to drill a couple of extra holes in the MDF for that all to slip through and get attached to the half inch MDF. The boxes are going to get hung on the side of the vocal booth with some keyholes, and we're going to plunge route those into the half inch MDF here with the router, drop down, and then back out that original hole with this special key router bit that allows us to add those holes. I got Travis, Chris's son, to help me out on this build. He's been doing a lot of the handheld video and just helping me out in general on this build. Shout out to Travis. Let's start the assembly. Now that we have all the pieces cut, let's put them together and start building these boxes. I'm using wood glue and some sheetrock screws to screw everything together with in the very beginning because I ran out of air nails. So you'll see me drilling and screwing everything together here in the beginning. Ultimately, I take most of those screws out and then air nail everything in the end. But everything gets glued together with wood glue and screwed. And here, some air nailing. And watch what happens next right there. Ow, dang. Right on the thumb. Be careful. All right, let's put the centerpiece in here. Glue that in place, and that's the divider of the box. So there's a right and a left because there's two fans, and each side has its own fan in it. Remember, there are two boxes, an upper and a lower. Only the upper unit has the exhaust fans in it. The bottom is merely a baffle for the inlet air. Let's start modifying these pieces that we bought at the retailer so that we can ultimately attach the hoses to them and mount them to the inside of the box. So we're gonna cut off the one side. You saw me cut them off with the tin snips, and we're just sanding that flat on the belt sander so that we can have a nice flat surface to mount the fans to. This is how the fans get hooked onto this flange so that we can ultimately hook on the hoses. Let's drill the holes so that we can attach the fans onto this flange for the hoses. I'm going to use a mastic to glue the fans onto these hose flanges, and this is what I have basically left over. It's used for sealing cracks in the concrete, like in your driveway, and it's what I have left over from doing some of that, and it's going to work really good here. You could just use some caulking or some sort of a spongy cement. Anything will kind of do. Now I'm going to glue the flanges in with some of this all-purpose Gorilla Glue. Some of the holes are a little bit big for this flange and need a little spacer. And I'm going to use some of this mastic again to put everything together. These are the bezels that the fans get mounted to, and the fan has our flange on it. And this is how this system comes from the Silinx, with these little rubber tabs that you pull. Highly suspect and not really strong enough for this application. Ultimately, we're gonna screw a couple of screws in there to get it all together. Let's drill the hole so we can pull the wire out to connect the fans to the controller. I'm gonna use this 4-inch class 1 flexible insulated ducting that I see many other people use for their vocal booths and sound rooms to keep things quiet. Now we continue to use that mastic everywhere here, and we just slip down the flexible ducting over that flange, and then we're gonna use some zip ties to hold everything together, and we're gonna do that for every single flange connection in this build so that it doesn't come apart later. Where I don't have long enough zip ties, I put a couple together, and we do that everywhere to make sure we have a good connection and it's all bonded really well and it doesn't come apart. Additionally, where those little rubber pull things were, I screw in some screws to make sure that those fans don't come off from those bezels. If you have a 3D printer, you can print all these vent hose adapters. And I do it both ways in this video so that if you don't have a 3D printer, you still have options. I basically am printing these flanges with some of this clear PLA, and I'm gonna paint them red so that it matches the detail on the rest of the booth. The 3D printed flanges are all used in the bottom inlet box. So there's no fans in this box, and I'm just gluing the four flanges into the holes using some of this all-purpose Gorilla Glue, and it works really nice. It sets up in a couple of hours, and it makes a nice seal in a few places. The holes are a little bit oversized, and I need a tiny little spacer. You saw me doing this previously. You can just use a piece of thin cardboard, whatever it takes to fill up the gap. We'll use some more of this mastic, just like we did on the other box, to connect the flexible hoses onto these flanges once they've dried. This is the same method that we used before. Put a couple of zip ties together if they're not long enough so that you can attach and securely connect the flexible ducting onto the flanges and get a good air draw through the box. Gets a little messy, wear some gloves. You can see the flexible hosing snake through each side of the box into that S pattern to hopefully deaden the sound for the inlet, and it's the same on the outlet. I use some shredded paper in the corners to take up that additional empty space, and then go through, put down some wood glue, and we're gonna glue the top on and seal up the boxes. I put down some clamps to help me line up the top, and then I just come through and I air nail the crap out of it. And of course, I do this for both boxes. Let's turn our attention back over to the vocal booth itself. I drill a series of holes that I previously marked out with a silver Sharpie onto the exterior felt, and then I come back with the jigsaw and I cut the holes out the rest of the way. I do this for the bottom and for the top, and this is where the boxes are gonna get mounted. Ultimately, the bottom is where it draws in the cool air from the outside. The top is where the fans are, and it's going to draw the warm air out of the top of the booth, out of these holes that I'm removing right now, so that it can stay cool on the inside and the boxes get hung on those four screws. And here you can see me hanging the box. It's a blind connection, of course, so it can be a little bit tricky, but ultimately I get them on there. Now, the other thing is the Silenx controller does not come with a way to mount it. There's so many shortcomings about this system that I really am unhappy with, and I end up having to drill a hole and make a special screw so that I can flush mount this thing later on. So let's go and Bondo all the little nail holes in these boxes. I also take a 1/4 inch round over bit and round and soften up the edges on this box, and then paint it a flat black. Here is the vent that goes onto the Silenx system on the top. Let's mount them onto the vocal booth and put them in their final resting place, and we'll attach the controller here as well, plug in the fans, and start to zip tie and do the cable management for all of this stuff. We'll roll the booth back into place. It has casters, so it's very easy for me to roll around, very convenient. One of the really nice features about this booth is that it's very movable and easy to roll around. And here I'm just nudging it back into place where it actually goes.
So we're in the sound booth right now, and the fan's running. You can't hear it, but I can. Driving me a little bit crazy. It's good enough for this build. It's not affecting the sound. You can't hear the sound on the from the lav mic that I can hear right now. Here's a brief recording without me talking to see if you can hear the fans. The fans are running at the lowest possible speed, and the air movement is just fine. Also, this entire video was recorded with the fans running at the lower speed. Many of you have asked why I built this sound booth with styrofoam and not like a rock wool. The main reason is that I don't want to deal with any sort of fiberglass batting or any sort of fibrous material like that. I hate that stuff, so I don't want to deal with it. This booth was never meant to be soundproof. I think many of you have the wrong impression about what a vocal booth is, or what this recording booth whisper room is. It's in my basement. It's shielded from a lot of noise already, and I just really need a nice dead space to record my YouTube videos in. It does not need to be soundproof for my use as a YouTuber. Talk about the Silenx system that I used. I bought it for $60 on eBay. It's okay. I thought it was loud to begin with. It has a bunch of shortcomings. There's no on and off switch. There's no way to mount it. But it's very easy. You can just plug and play. You don't need any electronics. There's the AC adapter. So for DIY, it's really good just for a build. And it's going to be fine, I think. In the long run, it's doing what it's supposed to do. It's keeping me cool in here. It's allowing me to record for longer periods of time and focus on what it is that I need to do inside of this booth. Let's take a look at the setting of the holes, not the setting, what it looks like back here. These are where the holes are. I currently have these pieces of foam over the holes right now. There probably needs to be some sort of a baffle that comes out of here and then up to help deflect the sound. Luckily, it's behind this monitor already, and it's doing an okay job. If you have an idea about how I can continue to reduce the sound even further without reducing the airflow, I would appreciate that feedback. Leave that feedback in the comments below. And then I think just final, this booth is meant to be a guide, or this series is meant to be a guide. But over time, it's become quite a popular video on my channel. It's a little bit out of the norm from what I normally do as a designer, but it is a making video, and I want to include that in what I do here. I also get a lot of comments about whether I would build a booth like this. And yes, I'll build a booth for you like this. It will not be cheap. It'll be about $10K. If I'm going to build you a booth, it has to be worth my time. And for it to be worth my time, I need to make some money. So if you don't have that kind of cash, don't bother asking. If you do, I'd be happy to build you one with everything, including a monitor, just like I built here, with the ventilation system, and then you pay for the shipping on top of that.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.